Hey, Bridgers, it's Catherine Haskins, one of the co-founders of the Bridge Club. I am so excited to do another podcast with you, and today's is going to be a little different for us. We are so excited to have Dr. Callie Harris with us. She is with Purina, and I'm going to have her jump in here in a minute and explain what her role is. And we're going to dive into nutrition just a little bit today and have a conversation about the ingredients themselves. So, hey, Callie, thanks for joining me here at the Bridge Club.
Hello, Catherine. Thank you so much for having me. I am so excited to have this opportunity to talk with you and to hopefully reach out to a few more people with this very important topic.
So let's back up just a little bit. Let's, you know, tell me your background, because I think you have a unique pathway than most veterinary students, correct? As you kind of went through and where you ended up in your career.
Absolutely. So I, let's see. Well, I graduated from vet school many, many years ago. I'm not going to tell you exactly when. And okay. I pursued a small animal rotating internship, which basically allows me to get a little bit more experience out there in the world to make some decisions about if I want to specialize or not. And so I did an internship and got bit by the emergency medicine bug. I'm an adrenaline junkie. So I enjoy critical cases. And so after my internship, I dove right into an ER vet position right here in the beautiful metro Atlanta area. And I practiced for many years until about 3 years ago, I made a very exciting and welcome transition into working for Purina. So I have been with Purina as a veterinary communications manager for almost 3 years at this point.
So that is so cool, because a lot of people in the profession are, you know, they don't jump into ER right away. It could be they get bitten by that bug at a different point, or they jump over after. And so that is exciting. I love our ER docs. I think you guys are phenomenal. But that's not why you're here today. We're going to actually dive into nutrition. And one of your, obviously, yes, being Purina, there's obviously passion around nutrition, et cetera. But one of the things that I found most interesting in our engagement has been about how every single ingredient has a purpose. But I have to say, you know, poor pet owners are confused as all get out, because all we see is the commercials online about fillers, about this, about that.
Right. And
I feel like it puts the veterinary professional in a really awkward place, and also understand what the nutrition really means. So how do you help address that with veterinary professionals?
You know, it is one of those challenging conversations that as a veterinarian, you're going to continue to have. And having the opportunity to work for a nutrition company like Purina has really given me the ability and the confidence to speak on nutrition at a very different level. And I recognize that not every practicing veterinarian gets that same type of background or experience or even exposure. But the way that I really encourage my vet students and colleagues to maneuver through this is to be confident, to recognize that you as a scientist, as a veterinarian, you do actually have an appropriate background to talk about nutrition and to make recommendations on what each and every one of your patients should be eating. Now, I get it from a consumer's perspective. There are so many options out there. And so it can get very confusing as far as picking the right food for your individual pet. And so as a veterinarian, especially a veterinarian that's working for Purina, I really want to empower my friends and colleagues to know that if you're making a recommendation from a reputable company that puts a lot of time, effort, energy, research, studies on products, then you can't go wrong when you're just trying to find a diet or a food that's going to benefit that patient.
So obviously one of the biggest challenges is, you know, brand affiliation. So we're going to set that aside for a moment. Let's dive into the science. Sure. I think the science piece is really the cool part about this whole thing. And I think, you know, as you just said, veterinarians are scientists. So let's let them kind of get their voice and bring that voice forward. So let's dive into the science of nutrition and the how every ingredient counts. How do we start into
That's
that
right.
conversation?
So where I usually like to start with is, and that's not to pick on any particular breed, but not any particular brand, excuse me. But anytime you're dealing with a pet food company that has a boarded nutritionist, boarded or scientists or researchers or people who have that background and experience and formulation of diets, then you're already at a good start, okay? No matter what brand it is, no matter who it is, but if you have a company that has the scientists, has the research, has the experts on their board, then you're going to really be in a good place to make those recommendations. Every ingredient does serve a purpose for all of those reputable companies, including Purina, meaning we don't have the time or really see a need to put ingredients in a diet that's not going to benefit or provide some level of impact for that pet.
So let's pick out just like a couple here, because I think that for our listeners out there, they're like, yeah, we know, you know, protein. Yeah. So let's dive into a couple of the ones that might surprise people as the value of that ingredient and what that does.
Absolutely.
Let's just for species specific right now, let's go dogs, and then let's highlight maybe one for a cat too. But let's focus in on kind of what that does, a specific ingredient that people may not be aware of.
Well, we could probably actually combine both species when we're talking about protein, because protein is an ingredient. It's a nutrient that comes up often from many of my clients. Everybody wants to focus on protein because guess what? Protein is fantastic. You know, it provides a lot of support for the cells. It gives energy. It's comprised of the building blocks, which are essential amino acids that both dogs and cats need, certain essential amino acids to thrive in life. So I think that's an excellent nutrient to talk about. But when people think about protein, they automatically go to meat sources of protein, right? Like chicken, like beef, like fish, right? And these are excellent sources of protein. But what many of our clients don't realize is that there's not one protein source that's going to provide 100% of those essential amino acids required by both the dog and the cat. And so that's where complementary proteins are going to come into play. And you might be surprised by some of those complementary protein options. They may not be ingredients that every consumer or every one of our clients is going to recognize. They recognize chicken, they recognize beef, but they may not recognize that corn gluten meal is actually an excellent source of protein.
So you mentioned corn gluten meal, and I think I can imagine people already, their ears perking up and they're saying, oh, gluten, uh-oh, there's that word.
Or even just corn. Even just corn, starting with corn.
People freak out on both of these. So how do we address that? Because there is that growing trend, and the veterinarian is being faced with those challenges. And if this is such a powerful protein source, how can we address that?
So it really starts with the veterinarian. And so that's why I think resources like the Bridge Club, like these opportunities for vet students and other vet professionals to come together and to gain that knowledge, information, and that confidence to talk about it. It's really our job and our responsibility to help maneuver our clients through deciphering that the pet food ingredient deck. And so it's really a matter of us just educating our clients and explaining and describing that corn itself, even though we think about corn as being just a carbohydrate or a starch, and many people feel that corn is actually a filler, when you're talking about a pet food company that utilizes it effectively, you're able to break up that corn kernel and utilize different parts of it depending on if you want the protein or the carbohydrate source or the corn oil, which provides a fat source. So it's just education. It's just awareness. It's understanding how that ingredient can be utilized. And then again, it falls on our shoulders to educate our clients about it.
So let's pick out one more ingredient. What's your favorite that you love talking about the most? And then obviously I'm leading everyone to the fact that we're going to have a bigger conversation about this, but what's like one of your favorite ingredients?
One of my favorite ingredients, and this is again, part of the whole teasing aspect of this podcast, I love talking about an additional fat source called medium chain triglycerides, also known as MCTs. The reason why I love talking about MCTs is because that is a functional ingredient that particularly in Purina products we utilize for different reasons. I start with that it's a fat source. It's a small fat source. It can be easily absorbed by the body, and it can be metabolized in a way to provide some additional energy sourcing for the brain, in particular with certain diets that we have out there. MCTs, we're not going to find that in every single diet, but again, it is a functional ingredient that serves a purpose that not many of our clients are going to know or even understand.
And nor do we want them giving MCT oil just because they hear this. That will be really critically important as well.
Absolutely. You want that MCT oil to be the appropriate amount and a purified source of it. And so, sure, there are many clients out there that say, hey, I've seen MCT floating around on Amazon, or I went to GNC and saw this option to buy MCTs or medium chain triglyceride oil. But again, that's just driving that expertise back to the veterinarian, because again, we are the scientists, and explaining why that may not be the best option to go and grab a big tube of MCT oil and slather it on pet food. You really want it to be done in the appropriate way.
So I'm so excited about this conversation. You and I could probably go through each one of the, you know, food diagram or all the listing of all the ingredients. And there's probably a million things that you're going to be able to share with us. But I have great news for all of our Bridgers out there. We are going to be having a conversation, and we're going to be doing it on January 15th at 7 p.m. And Callie is really going to be going through all the different nutritional profiles for both dogs and cats, and what this really means within how every single ingredient has a purpose. This conversation is for students, but there's a student in all of us. So if you are not currently a student and you would like to attend this conversation, just shoot me a note at Catherine@thebridgeclub.com, and I will make sure that we find a spot for you as well. But Callie, thank you so much. I can't wait to have this conversation with you in more depth on the 15th of January. Gosh, 2020, scaring the
potato. I can't believe that, number one, because here we are at the end of the year. And number two, I am stoked about this opportunity. This is one of my favorite topics, and I really, truly look forward to expressing or showcasing a little bit of the knowledge that I've been able to pick up. And I'm hoping, again, you know, my goal is to make sure that any information that I provide is just empowering those vet students and vet professionals. You know, we are just all better together as a team. And so this is just making sure that we are all on the same wavelength to give our clients the best information, the best recommendations.
Oh, Callie, this one's going to be awesome. Again, that is going to be on January 15th at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. You can register on our website, thebridgeclub.com. Callie, thanks so much. And we look forward to seeing you and hearing you next on The Bridge Club.
Awesome. Thank you so much.